anything of use?
To meet your maker.
Nothing will stand in my way. What do I have to lose? Fight, friend. To put my hands on everything.
The statue before you bears a familiar likeness. It is Balderan, the celebrated adventurer who founded the city of Baldur's Gate.
Peril floods my province. The palisades fall. The earth does tremble. The servants of shadow and blood assemble. Beyond lies the grand worm, deep in slumber, awaiting a true hero's advent, should my domain drown in torment. Be you the deluge, turn away. Be you the hero, answer true. Are you worthy?
Poetic nonsense. There is no worm. And no savior.
You sense neither life nor spirit within the statue. A powerful variant of magic mouth has been cast on it, allowing it to speak only recorded messages.
Ancient Ansor, hear me. A champion is proclaimed. The test begins. Let your judgment follow.
Two centuries walking this.
This place is quite a find. Imagine all the people going about their lives unaware of what their city is hidden away. Most of. I just know that my heart sinks if I let my thoughts wander. Of course. From the first time, perhaps. But in the meanwhile.
Always room for more?
Paintings hung on the wall. Almost like an art gallery.
Seems like a good moment to talk.
A good leader has the insight to find good counsel. As a war reaches its end, there is one who doesn't advise for the city's prosperity. Find him and strike him down.
This way. Let's see what's to be said.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have. Time to press ahead.
Let's get on with it. Onward in her name. I can tend to this.
Prison guard slides a warm meal into the thief's cell. The red-haired man has a 10-day left to serve, judging by the scratchings on the wall behind him.
No one's stopped me yet.
A true champion knows justice and eliminates those who stand in its way. Restore the balance of justice.
Another step forward.
The red-haired man.
Banished. But judgment must still be passed.
Give it a shot.
A champion burns bright, even when rushing waters and moaning winds threaten to extinguish the flames. Take the torch. Withstand the elements. Prove your courage.
Don't linger.
Into the shadows.
Blood comes easy these days. For mercy.
I'm heating up. I've got it. Kill.
Alright, Karlak, it's go time.
A lot on my mind and, well, in it. Moving ahead. These boots have seen everything. What to do? Moving in. Better not be cursed.
Pawns, king, queen? Is this Lanceport?
Your strategic wits. There is but one rule. The Dark King must fall in two moves. Are you a commander of armies, or a shivering pawn? Fodder for cleverer minds. May you always crush the wicked, be they pawn, knight, or monarch. Proceed. With courage does the hero march, fettered by the taxing chains of fear. A stalwart soul must ever persevere. With insight does the hero choose, guidance born of ancient wisdom proven. Peace, not strife, the undenied conclusion. With justice does the hero rule. Lead not the guiltless lamb to bloody slaughter, nor cleanse the lion's sins in sacred water. With strategy does the hero scheme. A cunning mind, 100 steps ahead, your allies close, your rivals stunned in dread. Worthy you are found. Go forth, hero. Seize your fate. and rise, great worm, heart of the gate.
Else, the great worm is nothing but bone and memories.
They're not yours, but the worms.
I am Ansor, heart of the gate, butchered in flesh, risen in spirit.
Ansor wends his way through your mind like an unstoppable river. Your body is unmoving, yet thought flows effortlessly between you. The spirit pauses, and you feel the astral prism stir. Ansor senses the Emperor's presence within it.
Answer me, Facey. Why have you come?
A deep sigh resonates within you. The torrent stills, only disturbed by the dragon's next words.
Brack. My words aren't meant for you. They're meant for him.
The Emperor stirs in the astral prism, then in you, calm, curious, and detached.
Balduran. Your presence has stirred me, as it ever did. I am awakened.
Ansor, it's been too long. We knew each other once, long ago. We crossed the Kalim together and sailed Yal Tengri. We built a city by the sea. Ansor was my friend.
Friend, yes. And more. Until you killed me. Have you come to dance on my bones, Balduran? Was slaying me not satisfaction enough?
Satisfaction? No. You left me no choice.
You had every choice. You were becoming illithid. I offered you merciful death. You chose to fight. And now you bring your thrall before me. How far has the great Balduran fallen?
Stillness. Ansur's consciousness hovers just above yours, searching, seeing.
Dear Ansor.
Enough! I gave you everything, Balduran. And you repaid me in slaughter. It is time I return the favor. Let my bones rise and the storms gather. Witness, Balduran. The final tempest has come. I am the heart of the gate. I am the one who roars. This time, you will not escape it.
Yes, here.
stay idle.
Lagilo! Just like old times.
Slow down.
Ready. Have to keep going.
Thank you.
for this.
This feels good. Yes.
Step quick.
Go.
Another fight. Let's go.
Gods, it's hot in here.
I've missed this.
Well, so much for peace.
My turn.
Let's have some carnage. Have some fun.
Nothing important is ever easy.
Unsaw. I never thought I'd see him again. My true identity is the one you've known from the moment we met. I concealed nothing from you. I simply left out the details that were not pertinent to our cause. But it seems you are interested in them. Such sentimentality. Very well. It's like I always told you. I was just like you. An adventurer who yearned for greatness. And in mortal terms, I achieved it. As captain of the Wandering Eye, I acquired enough gold to found Baldur's Gate. I stayed for a while to watch my city grow. But it was not enough. I grew restless again. The sea called to me, and I ran to her with open arms. Life at sea was not easy. Our last adventure was ruinous. My ship was destroyed. My crew lost. But my spirit was far from broken. I was determined to return in triumph once again. I heard of treasure in Moonrise. I strove to find it. What I found was an illithid colony, where I acquired a tadpole much like yours, and became a mind flayer, enthralled to the Elder Brain. It was Ansor who found me. Ansor who pulled me from the Brain's domination. Ansor who brought me home. He sought to cure me of my sickness, called on every healer he could find, nearly broke his spirit in the attempt. But he failed to understand. I wanted no healing. I was not sick. Of course I do. More so because it was Ansor. Even after he had exhausted all possibility of reversing my condition, he still clung to hope. I tried to convince him of my reality. I was on the cusp of greatness beyond my wildest dreams. But all he could see was a mind flayer. He came to me as I slept. A mercy killing in his mind. I saw the tears. I felt his grief. I had no choice but to kill him first. It was an act of self-preservation. Words easier said than lived by. Do not think that I am ignorant of what I have lost. I may not regret my actions, but I do regret that they were necessary. While the past is beyond my influence, the present is not. It is time we move on. Two Netherstones remain in the hands of the Chosen. We must find them before we confront the Brain.
Already feeling better.
Enough sitting around. Let's go hurt someone.
Something. Very well.
Afternoon.
Seems simple enough.
Do you address an archduke, Your Excellency?